Hello, and welcome to Marriage Minutes, where we look at the controversial plans to redefine marriage. Some people say this isn't a debate about redefining marriage, or even about gay marriage. This is about marriage equality. But it's not about equality. That's because full legal equality already exists. Same-sex couples already have the same legal rights as married couples under civil partnerships. The law already says there should be equality between couples who are married and couples who are in a civil partnership. That's why polls show that gay people don't regard same-sex marriage as very important. Only 4 in 10 gay people say that it's a priority for their community. When the civil partnership laws were introduced by the last government, it said civil partnerships would bring full equality for gay couples without altering the definition of marriage. Same-sex marriage would not introduce any more equality for same-sex couples, but it would redefine marriage over the heads of the public. Equality ought not to mean sameness and bland uniformity. Equality shouldn't mean forcing everyone into the same box. True equality understands that differences do exist and seeks to treat different people with fairness and justice. It's perfectly possible to defend the uniqueness of man-woman marriage and also respect the rights of others. The government's proposals to redefine marriage are the very opposite of equality. They would enforce a new meaning of marriage on those people who conscientiously and sincerely disagree with it. This would erode civil liberty. It would immediately compromise the freedom of speech and expression on all those people who believe that marriage is only between a man and a woman. That's got nothing to do with equality. That's redefining marriage for everyone.